Good morning to everybody. Namaste, speaking from India on this 74th our Independence Day. We are very proud, feeling proud and privileged to introduce to you our new event and a new project which we have started by the name of Friends of Earth. So everybody, welcome to you. It's always been happening like this, that we always try to launch. For the last so many years we started doing this, and every event that we start in India, one of some of the big events, we try to synchronize it with our national days, which are Independence Day and Republic Day. So to start with it, we start this today's day and the launch with our national anthem. So please stand up as a mark of respect and our commitment to the nation. Thank you. Please be seated. Thank you. Today, as we launch our site for the website for Friends of Earth, I am joined by my senior colleagues and the board member and my senior members. So we wish you all from our side once again a happy Independence Day. Before I take you further, I would like to speak to you or at least brief you on few points which are about what Heidelberg cement on this planet Earth is about. So it is necessary. So I thought, you know, it might be necessary for some of our people here to know about Heidelberg, what it is. Heidelberg cement, if you look at it, it is about 147 years of unparalleled experience in cement industry. Today we are one of the largest building material producers in this world and present in more than 50 countries across the globe. On the global presence side, 55,000 employees, leading market positions in aggregate, cement and ready mix concrete, about 3,100 production sites in more than 50 countries and about 187 million tons of capacity, including the joint ventures, and aggregate resources, what the company owns as a group, is about 19.2 billion tons, which is one of the largest in this world. Coming to the philosophy of the organization and the group, we want concrete to become the most sustainable building material on this planet Earth. And therefore, we are driving economic strength through innovation, achieving excellence in occupational health and safety, reducing our environmental footprint, enabling a circular economy, being a good neighbor, and last but not least, ensuring transparency and compliance of the highest standard possible. The long-term goal of the organization, whether it is the global parent or in India, we want our CO2 footprint to come down, and we are putting up research projects for carbon capture and all possible methods by which we are expecting that by 2050 we will have a carbon neutral concrete. So this is the overall objective of the group in terms of environment and sustainability is concerned. in terms of the group, excellent market position in all attractive and attractive product portfolio, focus on continuous growth in mature and emerging markets, and success factors which remain always a top priority are cost leadership, customer satisfaction, and operational excellence. Coming to a little bit now on the Indian context to it, Heidelberg Cement India came into existence in 2006. It's just a small organization with the acquisition of one company here. It was a 3 million ton company, and gradually the management has worked its way through, and today we stand at 13.7 million tons. So this is the growth trajectory of Heidelberg Cement India. Coming to the issues of environment. So as a responsible corporate citizen in India, we have a targeted that we will achieve a 2 degree lower ambient temperature in our plants. And these temperatures, what we are looking at is at a measured one inside the plant and one a kilometer away from the plant. And these temperatures are taken on a daily basis, twice a day, and we are monitoring it. We have come close to 1.2 degrees difference we have been able to reduce. And this is basically by improving the green cover in our plants. And wherever we try to, now we, through Friends of Earth, we will try to spread this green cover across the globe if possible. So this is one of the agenda which has been driven, and expected that by next year, we should be able to bridge this gap between 0.8, the gap which is there to our target. So by next year, we are expecting to bridge this gap. Heidelberg Cement in India, both the companies, it operates two companies. One is Heidelberg Cement India and another is Zuari Cement Limited. In both these companies combined, the company has achieved a water positive of 5.2x. That means we give more water back than we consume. So the target is to achieve higher and higher water positivity, and we are working towards that. On Indian environment, when it comes to CO2, today we stand at about 575 kgs per ton of cement compared to industry 588 kgs per ton. And we have a target to reduce the CO2 emissions by 40% from 1990 levels. Increased, how will we do it? It is increased focus on blended cement, low carbon alternative fuels, and we will try to maximize our renewable energy. So this is our roadmap. And the target is by 2030, we should be about 483. And we will try to see that this 483 does not remain a limiting factor. We improve on it. So there is no target as such. We will try to do our best possible. But this is as far as we are decided that we have to do this, and we will do it. Coming to Heidelberg Cement's conservation of environment and bird life. So I'm very happy to inform you that, and you will be also happy to know that on our limestone quarries, 117 bird species have been recorded and found. And there are about 86 common residents, 31 winter migrants, and 5 species listed in near threatened by ICMUN. And this study was done by BirdLife International, which was partnered by Bombay Natural Historic Society. So this is the data which has recently come to us, and we are very happy and proud that our teams are working at all the quarries to ensure that we become a very environment friendly organization. While our parent, the group, is extremely ahead of us, very, very ahead of us, and we have to do a lot of catching up. But we will do the catching up in India too, and we will keep our image as a responsible corporate citizen. That is our aim, and we will deliver against that. Some of the CSR activities, we have done a lot of CSR activities. I will not take too much of your time, but in terms of your, we have done road projects, we are doing rural housing, we are, you know, doing medical health checkups, and we are doing water in terms of sanitation needs, water availability, drinking water availability to the people. And even during the times of COVID, we are doing a lot of work for the rural society. You will be saying that, you know, why did I not touch upon the COVID, which is a very important subject today? I would prefer not to talk about COVID because every forum possibly today on this universe is talking about COVID. So I said, let us talk about environment today. One of the major initiatives which we have done very recently was the company in India, for every bag it sells, it is contributing 1 rupee a bag to feed the underprivileged. So far, we have been able to reach about 15,000 families so far. So this is one initiative in the area of COVID area to support the people, and this is where we are. Now I come to launching our Friends of Earth program, which is a very, very unique initiative by the company, and it is aimed at increasing the green cover. We think that if you make this world a better place to live, the only way to do is become ecologically friendly. You make it in a manner that the generations to come are able to breathe, because this generation which exists today has taken a lot from Mother Earth, and we have to give it back, and we have to restore the ecological factor of this world. So this is one of the event or the one of the program which we thought about, which was innovative, and we started with it. So I will explain to you as we go forward. So I formally launch before you the Friends of Earth program. Thank you for listening, and be seated, and now pay attention to for the Friends of Earth program, how it works. So this is the Friends of Earth logo. So you can connect to the Friends of Earth logo website. And this is the front page which you will land up on. And there will be pages after pages. So this will be one by one you can see. When you connect to the website, you will see these. This connectivity may be a little slow, so you may not be able to see it. What is this about Friends of Earth? I'll spend a little time on this. This Friends of Earth initiative was thought about to increase the green cover. What we are trying to do is we are trying to motivate people, including our channel network to begin with, because our business associates, our employees, and our own people, we will try to motivate them to put up trees. For this, we have chosen to become a little more systematic about it. We had a full policy guidelines given to our network. What we are doing is we are asking them to plant trees. The trees which we are planting are neem trees. There is a specification for a neem tree that it has to be minimum 6 feet and things. We are providing them, those people, our business associates, some assistance also to get the tree, to do the plantation exercises, and to keep this going on. Now, those dealers and channel partners who have done plantation, their names and their tags, what they did, will be available to you and seen on this website. They will be geotagged. The neem tree has been chosen because of its medicinal value. It is an all-weather tree, and the best part is that it gives you a very, very dense green shade during the times of summer, which is needed, and our country being a very tropical climate, you need a very dense shade during summers. And especially, my heart goes out to the labor which is working at the dealers and retailer shop. Sometimes they sweat, they don't have a shade to sit under. So we are promoting and telling them that put up this neem tree when it flourishes after some time. It will provide shade to your people also, plus it will provide you a lot of medicinal values also. So from that perspective, we started a neem tree and we are trying to work on this. What is the philosophy behind it? I have put a small note which you may go on this website and see later on, which is from my desk. So far, we have planted about 205 dealers have planted trees, retailers have planted one, and associates, our business associates, have planted 15, and employees have planted 16. Now, these trees are called as Heidelberg trees. These trees will, when the beauty which I am want to, I missed out one point telling you, that what we have done is that normally if you plant a tree, normally you won't take care of it. After some time you forget about it. So what we have tried to do is associate the plantation of the tree with the birthdays or the anniversaries or any function or occasion. So we say that you plant the tree on that day, you will have an emotional bond, it will be developed, plus there will be a nurturing. We will be putting up the pictures of all these trees. Anybody can plant these trees. Now we will open this to anybody. Anybody can put these trees and they can send us their pictures, and with the geotags, we will put them on the website and you will get a certificate for that once you plant a tree. So going forward, I'll take you to this. People who have made expressions, those people who give their comments, this also we will try to put as many as possible on this site so people can go and see this. The recent plantations also you will be able to witness, and the most important part of this website is that the trees will be geotagged on a map. So if you look at it, all geotagged trees which have been planted, some of them, not all trees, all the data is here available. Part of the data we could not upload because of the site limitations, but we are uploading, and there were some limitations of pictures also available. So people are sending us the geotags with lat long. Once these are available to us, we are continuously tagging it. So you will see the feel, look and feel how it looks. So on the zoom, on this map, you can zoom very clearly. And then on any tree, what you touch, okay, you will get a detail of what the plantation is, who has done the plantation, which date it was done, in which area it was done, and the dealer's name or your personal name can come in, and the picture of the issue here is that whenever you send every year or alternate years or 2 years later, when you send this tree plantation growing in front of you, okay, you will send us the pictures. For dealers and retailers, our people will capture the pictures, and we will honor our dealers who are one of the best plantation who manage their plantation. So we will reward them, give them recognitions, more of honorary recognitions rather than any rewards by financial needs. But the idea is that we should contribute from our heart, not for the purpose of sake of some revenues or anything. So the idea is that we will promote this culture, and every year when you put up the trees, this whole library for that tree will keep capturing and moving forward. As you go forward, maybe your children later on, when people grow old, they will be able to come to this site and see their grandparents, what did they launch. We are putting up a picture of their grandparents or those people who have planted trees in their shops, so they become a memorable event, and it continues to motivate them to plant more trees in the names of their family, in the names of their children, in the names of everybody possible. In this search, we have provided the names. It is a drop down menu. You can just put the search of it and you can go and locate your search. But we will develop this search engine to better that later on you can put your mobile phone, because that is registered, your email, and the site will take you straight to the picture. And then you can see the pictures, existing pictures and the new pictures, what you put up as a library, you will be able to see that. So this is one picture, the way it is. If I select one name, it goes to selects one plant only in the name of this person, and then the picture of the person appears, including the all the details when it was planted. Some of the I just run you through a small library of pictures which have been taken and how the tree plantation happens, what is the excitement which happens at the site, and people are very happy doing these plantations and feeling very proud to be contributing to the support of the nature, and to also express their solidarity to making this green planet more green and greener with time. As I mentioned to you, once you sign up and you plant a tree and you send us the information, once the data is uploaded, the system generates a membership number to you, which is a permanent membership number. You can put this membership number also and search your plant. The lat long of the plant are detailed. The place is there and the name person who is planted the tree is there, and the plant registration. The plant will be also registered by a number. So in each place there will be a number given, unique number. So from that we will be able to track the number of plantations which are happening. For anybody to contact us, The contact details are here in front of you, so anybody can reach us and contact us and provide us the detail. This website, we will receive more and more information from you people. The idea is now not only to limit this website to the people of our business associates, but to open it up and encourage more and more people to come forward and plant trees. They can plant any other tree, it's okay, but if they plant a neem tree, it would be very good in the beginning, but this is an option available to you. As Neil Armstrong said, one small step might one day become a giant leap for the mankind. And this is a small step from Heidelberg Cement India, and we hope that it will become a movement in the times to come, and we will be able to contribute in our own way, small way, whatever it is, to make our planet, our world, a wonderful place for generations to come to live there. So thank you very much, and for being here with us, being present in this webinar, and taking your time out to hear us out. And your suggestions are most welcome to us. We look forward to it, to make, and everything, what every suggestion what you do, we will try to implement and make this website more and more appealing and more user friendly. So thank you very much to all of you. And once again, wishing you a happy Independence Day to all Indian citizens and to those people who have joined from abroad and other places. Thank you very much for joining this event and making it a great success. It shows your commitment and solidarity to making this world a wonderful place for generations to come. Thank you very much. Namaste.